Hello and welcome to Finextra TV. I'm Hannah Wallace and we're here at NextGen Nordics P27 Momentum. Kindly joining me now is Liz Oakes from Mastercard and Lars Sjögren from P27. Hello to the both of you. Thanks for joining me.
Hello.
Now, you've just come off your keynote, P27 in action. So can you quickly tell me what was covered to begin with?
No, we were talking about some of the key deliveries from P27, that we will deliver a future-proof, instant-capable payments platform, that we will actually sort of move the Nordics from a fragmented landscape with many different platforms into one platform, that we also, by doing this, will increase improve the security, future-proofing that as well. And then finally, one of the key objectives also with P27 is that we will kind of, based on that platform, orchestrate and really encourage the fintech community and the banks, obviously, to really innovate on top of the platform.
Well, following on from that quite nicely, one of the things you brought up is what it's doing for collaboration. So what are the benefits there?
I think that in the Nordics there is a tradition to work together across the industry. There are a number of initiatives, some of the mobile payment schemes, for example, some of the legacy clearinghouses, also an example of sector collaboration. I think that this is now taking it to the next level. Instead of doing it in Sweden or in Denmark or in Finland, now we do it across the Nordics. In the Nordics we have so much that sort of unites us, much more than actually separates us. And we almost have very much the same background and the same language. Mm-hmm. And working together, we feel very much comfortable in doing that. So that is the collaboration we see today, and it's the next level.
But I think it's safe to say it's quite an ambitious initiative. Liz, would you say it's too ambitious, maybe?
It is definitely one of the most ambitious implementations we are seeing at the moment. I think the idea that four countries or three countries would try to work together to collaborate to create something that is cross-border and multi-currency is quite a significant move forward. I know that that's been done in terms of SEPA, for example, in Europe, but actually that was more of a transition to one single currency, whereas this is maintaining each of the individual currencies, but enabling all of the region to trade with one another, and also to trade with the rest of the world. And I think that that perspective, yes, it's ambitious, but it's also embracing the next generation of technology, it's embracing the next generation of standards, it's creating a framework for customer-centered design that's actually one step forward from what we've been doing up until now. So yes, it's ambitious. And I think it's a great sign today, and I think that the title of the session on Momentum really says it all. We have a lot of work to do together. We have a lot of work to do with the banks in the region, particularly to define how is this going to work? How are we going to work together? And I think this is something that for me really stands out in the Nordics, is that collaboration has typically been extremely successful. It does take some time. So yes, it's a big, ambitious project, but we have a very logical framework of how to approach that. And I think that really will lend to success.
And what about transparency and conflict of interest? Is this something that we need to worry about going forward?
We are established by six of the largest banks in the Nordics, and obviously they are competing, you know, on life and death, more or less, in the market space, right? But actually, when it comes to the infrastructure, they come together as a space where it's better to work together. So they are competitors, they are partners, and when we look at our partners, Mastercard is sort of the key partner today. Obviously, there are areas where we work together, and potentially areas where we will not work together, or potentially work together with someone else. That is just how things are today. And when you are building an ecosystem, you just need to be very good at navigating that, and be very transparent as well. Sort of, in what capacity are we meeting and talking here today? So for me, transparency is very much the key.
All right, and the title of your keynote was P27 in Action. So what should we be focusing on now?
For us, I would say that we have the timeline. We said from start that we will go live in 2021, not because we felt that was a convenient timeline and say that, well, we've had plenty of time. No, that was really to push ourselves. And sometimes we do get the question, are you moving too fast? And as the discussion we had on stage, are we actually moving too slowly, given the pace that the world around us is moving? So we have so many focus points. For me, as P27, we are setting up the company, we are building the infrastructure together with Mastercard, we are engaging in planning together with not only the owner banks, but other fintechs also, how to realize the first step early 2021. Not because it's easy, because it's important.
Liz, is there anything you'd like to add?
It's expensive to run multiple infrastructures in concurrently and to run multiple solutions for customers. So we do have to be mindful of the value that we drive as we go through this process and demonstrate that actually we're cutting over to new systems and we're creating new environments for people, largely so they can remove a legacy cost base themselves. So I think in some cases there will be pressure to move faster, and in some instances there'll be banks or organizations that want us to move slower. And we have faced this in multiple geographies and we know exactly what that looks like. And yes, sometimes that gets political. It gets complicated. There will be tension within any of these groups in terms of, you know, what should we do next? But we should always be mindful of the end customer. This is a network. Mm-hmm. And so if my customer can't reach your customer, that causes frustration and it pulls down the whole benefit of the entire endeavor. Mm-hmm. And so that's really what we need to focus on, is ensuring that we drive value every time we make a change and that we bring people along on the journey. And I think that's the real challenge, is demonstrating to people, why should you come on this journey at this pace? Mm-hmm. And helping people to achieve that.
And if there is one message to those outside there thinking about involving themselves in the P27 family or community, I think it's important that they start now so that they are ready when we are ready, because we will be ready in 2021. Mm-hmm. The question is really, will everyone else be?
Liz, Lars, thank you so much for your insights. I'll let you get back to the event.
Thank you, Hannah.
Thank you, Hannah.